Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen. Now, the Lord has spoken with me very, very importantly. The Lord did speak with me when I was in Brazil, and I've been waiting to come back to Kenya so I can share this information with your listeners and your viewers across the globe. And this is regarding the El Nino rains that are coming to Kenya. Yes, in that dream, there was a massive rain that took place, and a huge flooding happened. And then the voice said, look, even the crops have all been washed away. Again, look, even the crops have all been washed away. And then he said, he repeated, then the second part, he said, and especially because the crops were still very young in the field. And I understood also that meant famine was coming to the land. So it is a very important time for this nation to go in prayer, for people to be righteous. It is so important right now that all Kenyans receive Jesus. There's no question about this. That is the bottom line. That is the conversation the Lord is giving here. It is very, very important that this nation, regardless of what religion you are, that people may now receive Jesus and be born again, that when they're in right standing with the Lord may rescue them, when this calamity comes to the land. And that's why I keep saying that for those who are in this ministry, for those who are in the ministry of repentance and holiness, for those that have subscribed to the love of holiness, those that have subscribed to the love, to love righteousness, to love the ways of God, the highway of Jehovah, that you see in Isaiah 35, verses 8 and 9. Those that have loved this new way of being in right standing with the Lord, I have said that I'm perpetually and continually praying that when these rains and floods come, they will be saved by the long outstretched arm of Jehovah, the mighty God of Israel. And again, let me repeat the message here. The Lord says that massive floods are coming, and I saw the reporting. He sent one who reported to me by voice that, look, even all the crops have been washed away, swept away. And then he said, especially because they were young, the crops were young in the field, they were all swept away. And that to me meant that famine is coming to the land. Now, it's the king of Egypt, the Pharaoh, an atheist, an idol worshipper. When the prophecy of Jehovah came to him, the prophecy of Yahweh came to him, the prophecy of the God of Israel came to him, an atheist. He believed it, that the famine was coming, and he prepared Egypt, and that is what saved Egypt until today, a superpower at that time. Then how much more we in this dispensation of the Holy Spirit, the Christians and the other religions that have now heard about Jesus, how much more should we all receive Jesus and believe this prophecy and believe that for those whose names will be found written in the book, the way Daniel writes in Daniel 12, they will be delivered. The Messiah is coming. The work is plenty. I'm now preparing to leave all the way to Portugal and then head to the Czech Republic, Prague, and at the same time finish with a meeting in the Netherlands. That is just how much work there is in the field. But for those in Kenya, the message is clear. Be born again and be in right standing with God. Meaning, be holy and be righteous, that when such a thing comes, such a calamity comes unto the land, that the floods come and sweep away the crops, the saving hand,
the mighty saving arm of the Lord may rescue you, may save you, that you may be a testimony that indeed Jehovah, He is the Most High God, the living God. The Messiah is coming. I have seen the coming of the Messiah, and these are the signs of the coming of the Messiah. May those who have ears and those who are wise, may those who have little minds like children, minds that don't question, innocent minds, innocent hearts, may they believe this and see the glorious kingdom of God and continue in righteousness and holiness until He comes. Shalom.